I would say that our reaction, like everybody else's reaction, began with surprise, evolved into disbelief, and then quickly mutated into shock, because there wasn't much of a, I suppose we could all see that there would be a chase for lower values coming in the U.S., especially ahead of a contract expiry like we saw yesterday. But the idea that crude prices could go negative, while we'd all been talking about it for a couple of weeks, nobody thought it would really happen. So the shock settled in quickly. And then watching those numbers go to minus 30 as well, I think we're in a new world right now. We're all trying to understand what this means.
Dave, I can talk to you till we're blue in the teeth about the leverage plays, about the sub collars, about the synthetic short that was created until you actually run into your short put that ran into the money. We can talk about the retail investors taking a bath on this one, but that's all looking backward. Is this going to happen to the June contract? That's what people want to know looking forward.
Yeah, that's correct. So as the smoke clears this morning, that is the number one question in the market today. You know, we can all, as you say, we can all mull over the technical reasons why on expiry we hit these numbers yesterday. But anybody who thinks that the technicals were behind negative pricing yesterday is going to completely miss the point that storage is just as full for June, if not fuller, than it was for May. Already Cushing is 70 or 80% full, and that technically means it's closed for business. So we could easily see this play into the June contract pretty soon.
Yeah, I've got so many questions, and like you, we've been chatting to everybody most of the evening, and just everyone's aghast and amazed. But has Saudi won is my other question as well, because there is a question about whether this was by design or by default or what have you. But when the dust settles in this one, and we've asked our questions about the June contract and we're looking forward a bit more, has Saudi won?
Yeah, so Saudi Arabia and Russia have both won here, but it's a very pyrrhic victory, because while they long had U.S. shale production in their sights, and these numbers mean shale producers are absolutely unable to produce, and there's a meeting at the Texas Railroad Commission today to talk about these issues, they need to look over their shoulder, because Brent is not far behind, other crude benchmarks are not far behind, and the world is running out of storage. So what we saw in Oklahoma yesterday, not unlike the virus in Wuhan, we can see the oil market virus spread to the rest of the world very quickly here. Our estimates are that total inventory in the world could be exceeded by the end of May, beginning of June. So they better watch out what's happening here, because the celebration should be short and brief. And I got to think about what this means for next month.
Dave, very quick follow-up. I know Jeff's desperate to get in as well. The world can't run out of storage because they have this stuff in the ground, and that's always been my point. So will the supply just be turned off? Because, of course, everyone looks at the demand curve, but you and I and others in the industry look at the supply curve as well. So you can't run out of storage if you leave it in the ground. Will they leave it in the ground?
I think that this is the curse of oil. You have to keep pumping to keep making that money. And this is why I say Russia, Saudi Arabia, for that matter, the rest of OPEC, has to look very carefully, because, yes, you can leave it in the ground, but that's akin to shutting your shop and no longer selling your goods. I mean, what does that mean for the economies of Saudi Arabia, United Arab Emirates, Qatar, for that matter, Russia? So, you know, this is a global problem. You can leave it in the ground, but then what do you do with your cash flow? And they don't have infinite reserves, of course, as we all know.
Hi, I'm Giovanna Bersecci, and thank you for watching. You can check out more of our videos by clicking on the boxes on the screen. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more from CNBC International. Thank you for watching.